Cauchy nth root test or root test. If summation statement of the Cauchy nth root test is summation un is a series of positive terms such that limit n tends to infinity un hold to the power of 1 by n is equal to l. Then summation un is said to be convergent if l less than 1. Summation un is said to be divergent if l greater than 1. If summation un value limit n tends to infinity un is equal to l, this l is equal to 1, then you can say the series is test phase. For what type of the problems we can apply nth root test? You see, when the series is powers of n, the series is contain powers of n. For example, the given series, you see, in the form of 1 by 2 to the power of n, 2 power n, 1 by n cube, n power or number power n. Next, n to the power of n by n plus 1 to the power of n. So here power is, numerator is containing power n, denominator is also containing power n. Next, n to the power n square. You see, numerator contain power n. Next, n plus 1 to the power of n square. So for this also you can apply. Next to summation x to the power n by n square, x to the power n, n square. Yes, for this also you can apply. Next, x by n whole to the power of n cube, x by n whole to the power of n cube, whole to the power of n here, x by n whole to the power of n. Next to see summation 1 plus 1 by n whole to the power of minus n square. Power is what? N is there. So for this type of problems, you can apply Cauchy nth root test. Test the convergence of summation n is equal to 1 to infinite 1 plus 1 by n whole to the power of minus n square. You see the given series un is equal to 1 plus 1 by n whole to the power of minus n square. You can write as 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1 by n to the power of n square. So the denominator is positive, numerator is positive. Therefore, the given series is a series of positive terms. Now, numerator 1, denominator power n square. 1 plus 1 by n whole to the power of n square. So you can apply nth root on both sides. If you are applied the nth root, then it will become 1 by 1 plus 1 by n whole to the power of n square power 1 by n. Here this n and n square, one cancel, then you will have un whole to the power of 1 by n is equal to 1 by 1 plus 1 by n to the power n. Taking limit n tends to infinite on both sides, then you see limit n tends to infinite 1 by 1 plus 1 by n whole to the power of n. You know already this formula, limit n tends to infinite 1 plus x by n whole to the power of n is equal to e to the power of x. So this is 1 by e to the power of what? 1. E power 1 is nothing but e only. This is equal to what? L. Therefore, L is equal to 1 by e, which is greater than 1 or less than 1? Less than 1. Therefore, summation un is convergent. By which method? Summation un is convergent by which method? Cauchy nth root test. Test the convergence of summation x to the power of n by n cube. Given un is equal to x to the power of n by n cube. We here x is greater than 0. See, numerator is positive as well as denominator is also positive. Therefore, the given series is a series of positive terms. Now, this is powers of n. This is n cube. So, you can apply nth root test. Now, taking whole to the power of 1 by n, nth root for both sides, then x to the power of n by n cube whole to the power of 1 by n becomes this x to the power of n whole to the power of 1 by n by n cube whole to the power of 1 by n. This power n and nth root getting cancelled, then in this case un whole to the power of 1 by n is equal to numerator is x, denominator you can write as n to the power of 1 by n whole cube. Now, taking limit on both sides, limit n tends to infinite un whole to the power of 1 by n is equal to limit n tends to infinite x by n to the power of 1 by n whole cube. Now you see, we know the formula limit n tends to infinite, limit n tends to infinite n to the power of 1 by n is equal to what? 1. Therefore, this becomes x by 1 cube, that is x. So, what you can say from this? X is equal to L. By Cauchy and through test, we have summation un is convergent for L less than 1. What is L here? X. So, for x less than 1. Next, divergent for x greater than 1. If x is equal to 1, put x is equal to 1 in summation un. So, what is un will become here? What we have un is equal to? Un is equal to x to the power of n by n cube. So, if you put x is equal to 1, 1 power 1 is nothing but 1. So, we have 1 by n cube. Un is equal to 1 by n cube. Un is equal to 1 by n cube. This is in what form now? Un is in what form? Of course, sir, this is n cube we have now. So, can you apply n through test means? Of course, you can apply n through test. If you are applied n through test, this limit will goes to 1. This limit is goes to 1. So, in this case, what we can say? The series is test fails because limit is 1. So, this is in the form of, we cannot apply n through test. Now, this is in the form of summation 1 by n to the power of p, where p is equal to 3, which is greater than 1. Therefore, the series is convergent by p test. Finally, the series is convergent by p test. Finally, what we can conclude means the given series of x to the power of n by n cube is convergent for x less than or equal to 1, the series is convergent, divergent for x greater than 1. For x less than 1, we have convergent and x is equal to 1 also convergent. Therefore, we are combinedly written for x less than or is equal to 1, the series is convergent. Divergent for x greater than 1. Test the convergence of 1 by 2 to the power of n, n cube. You see, numerator is 1, you have denominator 2 power n into n cube. Both are powers of n only. Na? So, given un is equal to 1 by 2 power n into n cube. Taking a nth root on both sides, then it will becomes 1 by 2 power n whole to the power of 1 by n, n cube whole to the power of 1 by n. So, this is un whole to the power of 1 by n will become 1 by 2. N and 1 by n getting cancelled. This is n to the power of 1 by n whole cube. We know that limit n tends to infinite, n to the power of 1 by n is equal to 1. For this problem, you see, if we are applied limit n tends to infinite on both sides, then limit n tends to infinite 1 by 2 into n to the power of 1 by n whole cube will become, this term will become 1. So, finally, what we have? 1 by 2. This is what value? Limit value. Limit is equal to 1 by 2. Which is greater than 1 or less than 1? Less than 1. Therefore, summation un is convergent by nth root test, or Cauchy's nth root test. Next problem. Test the convergence of summation 1 by n to the power of n. By the observation, here un is, they are given 1 by n to the power of n. So, again, numerator is 1 and denominator is the powers of n. So, you can apply whole to the power of 1 by n on both sides. If you are applied, this will become 1 by n. Whole to the power of n and power n will be getting cancelled. Now, apply limit on both sides. Limit n tends to infinite. Un whole to the power of 1 by n is equal to limit n tends to infinite 1 by n. 1 by n. As n tends to infinite, 1 by n goes to 0. This is limit value. So, limit is here. L is equal to 0, which is less than 1. Therefore, summation un is convergent by nth root test. Thank you for watching this video.